I'm told he's Jamaica's only rallycross driver, and he's been making a name for himself. Well, I think he did that a long time. And Jamaica on the rallycross track. Fraser McConnell joins me now via Zoom. Fraser, morning. Welcome. How are you?
Morning. Thank you for having me.
It is our pleasure. First thing, what is rallycross? What is that?
Rallycross is a mix of rally and circuit on a very short track. It's built to be very intense and, you know, short-lived. The race is no longer than 5 minutes, but you have a 700 horsepower car with five other cars like the same around you, and everybody's going flat out for those the entire time trying to get the win.
The race is less than 5 minutes?
It's about that. We have the track is about 1 kilometer, and we go around it in 40 to 45 seconds, depending on the track.
Which means you can't make any mistakes at all. I mean, a slight mistake and you're in trouble, don't.
Yeah, no room for error, and there's big jumps and a mix between gravel and tarmac. So it's a slick tire as well. So you have to be balancing the grip with the power and trying to pass people and not trying to make people not pass you. So it is a lot going on in a very short period. And like you said, there's no room for error.
Yeah, I've watched car racing a lot, and they have the cages and stuff. How safe is rallycross? Is it any different from... I saw a horrific accident with the other day, and the driver came out of it beautifully.
It's safer to be harder. Mommy and daddy said no more. Her heart couldn't manage it. So it had to be four wheels, and then got into go-kart when I was around 11.
Yeah, but where did this come from? Where did the fascination for speed, I was going to say cars, but you said motorbike first. So where did the fascination for speed come from?
I narrow it down to the rally driving, because I've living in Bogwalk on the True Juice farm my whole life, and seeing the rally cars pass my house every year, I would look at them and say, you know, I want to do that. It looked fun.
Yeah.
So I guess built up the passion from there, and like I said, started with bikes because it was the easiest option, and just every year we put ourselves against better competition.
Yeah.
And we proved to be, you know, up there. So it's all been a step-by-step process, and now we're racing the best in the world, and now we're starting to beat the best in the world. And
yeah,
you know, my goal is to be the best in the world.
Yeah, and I'm sure you're close to that. We've already spoken about the safety of the sport, but have you ever been in anything kind of scary that you say, no, so I'm going to continue with this?
If you don't crash, you're not finding the limit. And like with these cars, you have to be right on the limit the whole time. So yes, I have had a few offs, we call them.
and mommy and daddy, you know, say, no, sir, stop this now. Go to church.
No, they're solid, man.
Yeah, you just came from Italy. Tell me about that. What was that about? Because you didn't compete, did you?
No, so the series is called Extreme E, and they had called me to be the championship driver. And essentially that is being there for a reserve role if any of the teams have a driver is ill or not able to race. I would fill that gap, but also, I was the development driver. So they have one of the partners is Continental Tire. And since the terrain is so rough and aggressive on the tires, it needs a lot of pre-work. So I would go out there and, you know, get the compounds right and the pressures right. And also, since it's an electric car, I was working with the engineers to get the right temperature setting, because, you know, battery power will vary the temperature that goes into the battery. If it gets too hot, can't really work in those scenarios. So it's a lot of development work to make sure that the races run smoothly. And you know, one of the drivers was feeling sick before the race, and I got thrown the team shirt, and I did the whole track walk and everything, but he felt better. So
okay, you know, forgive my ignorance, but the electric car and the gas car is the same kind of drive or no?
For the most part, yes. But when you start to look at details as us race drivers, though, the last bit of performance is always in the small details. And that's where you have to play to be at the top of the game.
Okay.
So in that sense, yes, they are very different. But from the outside, it looks quite the same. It might sound a little different, but yeah, Believe it or not, the electric car is a faster machine than the regular combustion.
Wow, didn't know that. My producer tells me that you signed a contract with two different racing teams. If that is so, explain that.
So this year I'm racing the full season of Electric. It's called Group E, and they're playing that on the Group B era. Was these crazy cars back in the 80s with, you know, 1,000 horsepower, and it was the whole talk of the town, and still is. But now with this new era of Electric, they are faster than the Group B cars, and we've dubbed it Group E. So I'm racing the full season of Group E, and that's 10 events throughout the world, and also the first three in Europe with supercars. So it's the first event was actually interesting. I would jump from the electric car into the supercar.
Yeah.
And it was a task, because like I said, when you play with those fine margins at the top, it's hard to separate, because you have so much mental preparation going into the race that I had to have basically two switches between these two cars.
Okay.
And it was a challenge, but as you can see, it worked out quite well.
Yeah. You're still a young driver, rallycross, but one day I'm going to see her drive against Fraser McConnell, or not Fraser McConnell, Lewis Hamilton, or one of them people, or you're not going into Formula One. You're not going there.
I mean, I'm not going to ever close that door of opportunity, but rallycross is quite a different genre than Formula One. If I was presented the opportunity to drive a car, you know, I would jump at it immediately. But right now, the focus is rallycross and, you know, all things racing go. So
yeah.
If you want me to race a lawnmower series, I'll jump in a lawnmower and race it too.
Yeah, man. When you move again?
I go to Sweden in 2 weeks, so round two of Nitro, where I'll be doing again the double class. And yeah, we're number two in the season.
Yeah, man. Be safe, my friend. Good to see you this morning. Stay safe. Say hi to the family for me.
Yeah, man. Look, thanks for having me.
Yeah, man. Look after yourself and keep winning. Keep winning, right?
I'll try.
Yes, man, for sure. Fraser McConnell, rallycross driver, and much more, I'm sure.